The main focus of this class is exactly how do we track things like start time, end times, batches, unit batches, sub batches. How does all that fit together with the PI system? Well, first of all, let's take a look at a little bit about batch and what kind of data surrounds a batch process. Well, obviously there's duration and there might be temperatures and pressures. There certainly are batch IDs and products being produced. Sometimes there's recipes. All processes have steps. So there's a lot of different data, types of data that go into a batch. And what our batch system does is it generally separates everything into one of two categories. The first category you're already familiar with, process values. These are all variables or values that are tracked based on what you're producing. In a batch context, these are going to be aliases for tags that you're already measuring. What we bring to the table with the batch processing are the batch details. And these are things like batch ID, the product and recipe that's being produced or used. What are the steps in the process? Most importantly, duration and triggers. Those are two key aspects for the batch-related data in the PI system.